on New Year's Eve. So anyway, we look back over the year, Tam, and Scotland's men's team getting closer to qualifying for a tournament. Are we still kidding ourselves?
No. I think we do have a good young team who like playing for each other. They do have age on their side. I was quietly impressed and maybe even fearful, Stuart, when it was pointed out after England's demise at the World Cup, the very fact that in 4 years' time, their team will still be a team of young guys, maybe entering their prime, all kind of maybe mid-20s, but need to much more than about 28, 29, you know. And I think we could be heading that way. We've got the Scotland team, when did we ever say this in years gone by? Almost picks itself. Mm. But I'm going to say what I said the very day he got the job, the time before he got the job, when he was even, you know, quoted for the job. Leave it to Steve Clark. And Steve Clark, I trust. Let the guy get on with it. And I'm feeling really good about the next one.
Well, I think
we'll be there.
I agree with you on trusting the manager to lead us, and I hope sincerely he does. I was one of many, many people that were calling for him to get the job and to do that kind of efficient way that he works with clubs and indeed now with the international team.
I'll tell you what, it was the year for memorabilia because three absolute toppers, and I think I'll give you them in the order that I enjoyed these stories. You had Steve Hodge, of course, former England player, who had Maradona's jersey from the hand of God.
Yeah.
And he gets £7 million for it. But he was cute and clever enough to announce before the auction that, of course, he would be making a large charity donation.
Yeah.
So let's even say he gave £1 million to the charity, £6 million in his skyrocket. Good on you, Steve. Don't grudge you a penny of it. And then, in keeping with the same game, we had the referee from that match who'd always kept the ball from the Diego Maradona Hand of God game, and I think he got £2 million.
Yeah, not bad.
But then, in terms of setting yourself up for life, Stuart, at the World Cup, Cammy Devlin of Hearts managed to get what was Lionel Messi's jersey from his 1,000th professional game. He swapped jerseys with him that day, and you think, Cammy, that's you made for life, pal.
Absolutely, and good on him.
Briefly, what about our own teams? If I'd have asked you St Johnson highlights just whatever, 2 or 3 years ago, it was easy. It'd all been about silver polish and trophies and everything. Yep. I would suggest for the outside looking in that one of your highlights this year might be the fact that you kept your manager, Callum Davidson.
It was a hugely divisive topic amongst the fans. And in some respects, you know, we've always said that football fans are fickle. And when a team's doing well, they're behind the manager. And when they're not, the manager's one of the first to get it. And I thought it was sad, actually, that Callum took some of the stick that he took. But I also understood that quite a lot of the people that were delivering it are hardcore St Johnson fans. They're no fly-by-nights. They're people that care about the club. They didn't think the quality or the standard of football was good enough. They thought that we'd maybe brought in too many ageing players. And then, of course, once he managed to shape his team, we've had a great season so far. We're, you know, top five just now. You know, possibly, potentially could go higher. Aspirations, obviously, to finish in the top six. Maybe the aspiration for another wee sniff of Europe, because everybody loved us getting a draw away in Galatasaray on the telly.
Yeah.
So, yeah, much to look at.
Well, on the sniff of Europe, the one thing I'll say, particularly with a festive spirit in mind, Graham Alexander, obviously, you know, there wasn't a lot of Millwall fans too disappointed to see him go.
Yep.
But he did finish as fifth in the league last May there. We did get into Europe, and I'm proud to say, of course, Stuart, really, really proud. It's always Celtic and Rangers fans you hear gloating about us, but Motherwell did our bit for the coefficient, albeit the Irish coefficient, but with that toasting with Sligo Rovers. But yeah, mixed emotions for a Motherwell fan, and again, see when you think about next year, looking ahead to the end of next season, I always say the same thing, Stuart. Keep us out of the bottom two, and I will be absolutely delighted.
Yeah, you escape, and it's a big feeling. We got our win at home against Inverness in the second leg of the playoffs, and there was the sense of kind of relief when the third and fourth goal went in and you knew you were across the line. It was joyous to behold, although it meant that two of the players, Callum Henry and Sean Rooney, were destined to go south, and both of them done quite well down there, so that's always good news. But one thing that I have noticed this year, and it's very much a phenomenon of 2022, and that is the way in which we now have cultivated a listenership that insults us.
Yes, right? Absolutely.
Things like, this is the most risible rubbish I've ever been forced to listen to.
Yes, but definitely keep them going next year.
Yeah, because there's too much of a tendency in the media for people to be self-congratulatory. So it's sometimes good to be brought down to earth. And also, what I love about it is teasing out the levels of degradation and hatred that
absolutely
they can bring.
I think we should actually put up an annual award for the best insult the show receives.
Well, you're listening to Off the Ball's Hogmanay special.
Let's have another wee bit of music.
Oh, you'll take the high road and I'll take the low road, but I'll be in Scotland up for you. But me and my true love will never meet again on the bonny, bonny banks of Loch Lomond. By yon bonny bank and by yon bonny brae, where the sun shines bright on Loch Lomond, where me and my true love wherever walk again on the bonny, bonny bank of Loch Lomond. Oh, you'll take the high road, I'll be in Scotland up for you. But me and my true love will never meet again on the bonny, bonny banks of Loch
good to have some of the younger team on board, and a TikTok star that's been very, very popular in Scotland over the last year. She's an advocate and a supporter of Scots language, and that was Lenny Penny. Now, Tam, you missed out on this because I think you were away that week, and so therefore Ray Bradshaw was sitting in your chair, and we asked the Off the Ball listeners about Scottish words and phrases you'd only hear at the football.
I can imagine my granddad saying this so much. So, guys, it has to be bohid.
Yeah.
And conversely, what I was thinking instead of conversely, I heed the ball.
I heed the ball.
I heed the ball. I can envisage so many players. What was the... Who's the guy that was at Falkirk? Was it Kevin James? He was about 6'10" or something
like
that?
He was 6'7". Yeah. Let's get this into perspective. And he came to St. John's.
I always get him and the Undertaker from the wrestling mix.
Outrageous...
I remember they played... when Falkirk were in the Scottish Cup final, I think maybe mid-90s, I remember... my grandpa just calling him a heed the ball the whole game, whole game. Football in Scots. This is from Cathy Wampus on Twitter. Football in Scots. Insert team name. So right now we could go Hibs, Partick Thistle, Workeek the day.
Yeah.
Gone yourself, Lenny.
Why is it that Dreek is spelt the way it's spelt, but Keek is spelt differently?
Len, can you answer that?
Is there a philology around that?
I would say that Scots doesn't actually have what we call a standardised orthography, which is that a set way of spelling.
Really? Yeah.
So no matter what way you're spelling something, if
it's
it matches the way... Yeah, that's what I love about it, is you can't be wrong.
Yeah.
So
wow, I didn't know that.
The way that you're spelling Dreek and Keek, if they sound the same, you are more than entitled to... Yeah. Spell them the same, which is good. But what I love about Scots spell is that it's kind of phonetic, so you don't have to sit and worry about pronunciation.
I'm going to ask you this.
Yes.
Partick Thistle allegedly were Keek.
Yes.
Was the game Dreek?
Probably. It was in Greenock, so yes.
It's almost certainly. We've just thought of a great idea.
On you go.
Priscilla Chinchilla. Is she Peruvian? I think she's
She's South American.
So here's a young woman. No long, I mean, I'm saying 20-year-old, maybe.
Yeah, I
and
think
she's
about that.
A Latin American footballer who's come to Scotland to pursue her career. A great name, Priscilla Chinchilla. Okay. I wonder, is there a possibility that Lenny could do a wee session with her talking up the Scots words she needs to know?
Oh, that, do you know what? That could be an amazing, there'll be teams out here, and I'm thinking Motherwell, Hibs, who are really on top of their social media. Signing someone from Italy, somewhere in Central Europe, something like that, and Lenny or Ali or someone like that, a Scots language expert coming in and just talking through it.
Coaching
that,
them.
That would be box office. Who was the guy Hibs had who really got into it? He's at Livy now, Omiyonga. And he seemed to really embrace Scots culture.
Yeah.
That would be... Yeah. If you are part of a social media team for a team, get in touch with that.
Aye, we could make that happen.
Would be brilliant.
Priscilla Chinchilla is the one.
Text and emails.
Ray.
So many Scots words coming in here. David Scott, simply one word: stushy. Sushi. Great. Hi, Stuart and Ray. Can you ask Lenny if she is familiar with the word ramscooter?
Ramscooter.
My gran used to shout away in ramscooter when we were annoying her. Always thought it was a funny word, John and Coatbridge.
I haven't, but you know, that's my favourite thing ever is when I find words I haven't done, because I'll just add them to the list.
Yeah. Puggy67 on Twitter, Tanner Ball perfectly sums up a certain type of player in only three words. A Tanner Ball player. Kevin Donnelly, I hated visiting that groon, it's a coupe. my good Sandy's got absolutely mock it. Just so good. And there'll be people tuning in that don't have a clue what that means, which is so funny as well. Walter Marshall, hello all. Walter in Sheffield here. A Scots word not used as often as it might be in football reporting can be found here. As Harry Hood was poised to pull the trigger, Doug Bailey bringed them down and the referee pointed to the spot. So bringed.
Bringed,
is that, what's that, Anise? I don't know.
Well, you bring in as you push in with extra force.
Ooh.
And also, if you're, I mean, let's say that you're at the dancing, the idea of bringing in is that you do it with a certain swagger and self-confidence, you know.
So how often were you bringing in your youth, Stuart?
Oh, I was a massive bringer back in the day.
At what point were you just like, oh, this could be my future?
I think that the Scotsman DM'd me and asked me to write an article about me, and I was like, why though?
Did they DM to ask to write an article about you, or you to write an article for them?
No, they wanted to write an article about me.
Okay.
And I was like, why do you want to do that?
Yeah.
Have you met me? And then it wasn't until, like, I think I was at work and I was just like working in the restaurant and someone came up.
Getting recognised?
Yeah, someone came up and was like, are you Lenny? And I was like, yes. Are you okay? Can I help you? And they were like, no, we just like you're working that. And then I went into the toilets and cried because I felt so disappointed to them. I was like, you're expecting someone put together and not anxious, and here I am, 5'3" of absolute mess.
Yeah. There's a lot of pressure to get their dinner right, isn't it? At that point.
And the thing is, I think it's one time someone recognised me and then complained. And I was like...
Complained to you?
Complained to me about the food, and I hadn't made it, so I was like, please don't tweet about this.
Yeah, because this was something so out of your control.
And
so,
I started saying it wasn't me when people would ask me, because it got to the point where I was... Because whenever I had my hair down, people would recognise me more. Yeah. So I'd just be like, no, sorry, I look a lot like her, but that's not actually me. Because someone shouted across...
I'm actually Eleanor Morton. Like, just move on to that.
I wish someone shouted across the bus station, have you got your boiler fixed, hen? Because I'd been tweeting about getting my boiler fixed. And I was just like, oh.
Excellent. Yeah, good.
But also, to everyone else that has come around, that sounds so horrible and rude, but it's actually just concerned.
Yeah,
nice.
I was lovely, but by the time I registered that they'd seen it on my Twitter, I was like, oh, I'm sorry, I'm on the bus now. So I kind of just awkwardly waved out the window.
The awards were held recently. Yeah. Did you win one or present one?
I presented one. Won one last year.
Way to drop that in. I like it.
Yeah, sorry, I'm actually Scott's Performer of the Year 2021.
Once you've hit 23, it's over. Don't worry.
Sorry.
So, won that, and then. So you hosted the awards. How was that?
I mean, it was the second year hosting, and it's still, you think it would get easier, but I'm...
So you hosted and won one the year before?
It was so awkward, because they knew I was going to win, but I didn't. So they were like, oh, for this one, we're going to get you off, so it's not awkward, you're reading your own name. And then they called my name for winning, and I came out and started crying, because I was so anxious.
That's a theme, isn't it?
Literally. I just cry. I'm like one of those fainting goats. Anytime anything happens, I'm like, oh, I'm sorry. Yeah.
And this year, because Marilyn Robertson won one, a brilliant stand-up.
Amazing.
With the community, has social media